Here we go.
Here's Jones. Now the starting group for the visitors. Poke loose. Outside Johnson. With some arc. That shot missing. And here's Jones. Pass to Brooks. Here's the machine. Outside Jones. Six to shoot. Can't hit that one. So Indiana will take it the other way. Now Stewart. About a minute into this first quarter. Left side Johnson. Count the basket.
Defensively, you can't afford to get stuck on the pick.
That's one that the coaches will watch tomorrow with that player. You hate to see him give up in that situation.
Now here's Brooks. Shoots over Stewart. That one's wide left. And we're about a minute and a half into the first quarter. Johnson passes to Thompson. And that's good. His first bucket of the game.
Well, if you're giving up that much height, the only thing that you can do as a defender is to foul him.
Brooks with it. Pass to Jones. Ooh, Thompson with the block. Driving to the basket. Now Johnson. The rebound by the machine. They need something good to happen here.
Yeah, they've gone way too long without a score.
Stewart with it. Checked by Brooks. Stewart against Brooks. Pass to Johnson. Thompson with a screen. Now here's Johnson. Down low. And the slam dunk by Thompson.
Oh my. What a display of effort.
That's his bread and butter, right? Chasing down the boards.
Stick with fundamentals there. Shot goes up, box out, or he'll destroy you.
Brooks outside. First quarter of play, and we're about 3 minutes in. Misses from short range. Johnson passes to Stewart. He shoots a three. Offensive board. Looking to end the drought. Thompson pulls it in. Thompson's got four rebounds in the game. And first quarter, we're about 3.5 minutes in. Very pretty alley-oop.
Saw his teammate with a path to the rim, and boom, lobbed it up there beautifully.
Very smooth catch and finish. Now here's Brooks. Boy, he's been patient so far. Nothing yet on the scoreboard. Deflected! Here's Stewart. Second shot opportunity, and that's 2 points on the layup.
And why go away from attacking inside if the D has no answer for you? They're giving up a lot of points in the paint. That's something they have to address here.
Yeah, coach knows that. They know that. In the timeout, they're going to hear about it, make the adjustment.
So it's the home team now, looking for their first basket of the game. They need this. The shot's good.
At last, their cold streak is over. They finally found something that worked.
Yeah, the point is to score, so getting that first one, that always helps.
Now here's Stewart. Boy, no scoring yet from him, but that's likely to change. Lays it up and banks it in.
They played with fantastic energy from the opening tip.
Yeah, you wondered if they would take some time to find their A game. They did it at jump ball. They've been awesome tonight.
Here's Jones. Brooks outside. Outside Jones. Some solid defense from Stewart.
That's not going to make you a favorite target of your teammates. They'll think twice about feeding you if you're going to keep missing layups.
To the paint. The rebound by the machine. Brooks outside. Outside Jones. 4-3. He can't get that one to fall. So Indiana will take it the other way.
Give him a little credit. Take some guts to keep shooting if you're struggling this bad. It's getting a little bit ugly right now.
Stewart with it. Check by Brooks. And the layup is good.
Boy, absolutely no rim protection, leading to a lot of easy buckets here.
Pass to the machine. And there's a pick. And here's Jones, covered by Johnson. And he got the whistle on the way up. So he'll be headed to the line for a pair.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
And he knocks down the first one. Good on both. Indiana on offense. They're on a 14-4 run. Pass to Galloway. Off target at the rim.
The way they've gotten after rebounds has been impressive.
Left side, Jones. Missed it. Now 0 for 1 on this game. 10 points separating these teams. To the middle. Here's Thompson. And it goes. As the official calls the foul, count it, and he'll shoot one more at the line. And a closer look here at the scoring breakdown for Indiana.
Guys, right from the start, it's been apparent they're determined to establish a presence in the paint.
I'm loving the ping-pong action of the ball tonight. A decent number of assists so far.
Jackson, he's checked in for Jones. That free throw's good from Thompson. And here's Jackson. There's a screen. Shot clock at 6.
And just a lack of fight right now on the defensive end.
Right? At least on that slam it was. That's one way to let a team back in the game.
You have to credit the aggressiveness offensively, because that's when you make a play when you really need it.
Pass to Thompson. The 15-footer. That shot off the mark. Goes up from the block, and he can't get that one. So Indiana will take it the other way.
And they've come out with a fearless approach on the boards.
Back to Galloway. Thompson with a screen. From 11 feet away, it's tipped. There's a screen. And there's the rejection. Here's Galloway. Looking for his first basket still in this one. 1:50 left in the opening quarter.
And you never want to give a shooter like him a clean look.
Goes. Jam that one home.
Oh, I love this guy. Even when they're trailing, he works hard to put on a show.
Hey, that might be just what they need right now. And that replay courtesy of the AT&T 5G Slam Cam. Thompson in the post. And a foul called on the way up. So he'll take 2 from the free throw line. That free throw is good from Thompson. Both free throws good from Thompson. 1:19 left in the first. They set the pick. Here's Howard. Up again. Great positioning on the putback.
So far, rebounding has been a focal point for them.
Time called here. Indiana decides to talk it over. A minute four left to play in the first. Here's the pick. Off with the layup. There's the triple. He can't hit that time.
And the defense got away with one there. I mean, that's the shot he typically makes.
Oh, deflected. About 7 seconds separating the shot and game clocks. And he lobs it up to the rim. Throw it down on the lob.
I would imagine it's nearly impossible to not get fired up after that play.
Grant, check these guys out on the bench. Their reaction says it all. They are fired up. He got it up in time, but it would not fall for him. And so the first quarter is in the books. They lead by 7. And back to the start of the second quarter in just a moment. If you're just joining us, we played through one quarter in this one. And what do you guys think about the visitors here in this one?
Yeah, showing grit on the glass is a good way to gain an advantage. They controlled the boards in the first.
Well, if you get physical out there, you can control the glass, and that helps you to control the pace of the game.
Indiana on offense. 13 points was their biggest lead of the game. Now Stewart. Still getting warmed up offensively. No buckets yet in the game from him. And for Indiana, Brooks right side. Just 5 to shoot. 14 feet away. And so he draws the foul, headed to the line to shoot a pair. And he makes a first. And that one goes in. 2 from the line that time.
Well, when he gets into a groove at the free throw line, it doesn't just last for tonight. This might be 2 weeks, 2 months, something like that.
Throws it up high.
And the lead increases on a crazy offensive sequence.
Man, the dunk alone would have been incredible, let alone the fact that it came off a pinpoint pass. To the inside. To finish it off. A beauty.
Playing from behind, it's amazing he chose a dunk with that high a difficulty rating.
Yeah, no question. That was a stellar move with plenty of swagger. Now here's Stewart. Well, he hasn't put up any points yet in this one. Another shot. And the bucket counts. And he is on his way to the line. He'll try to make it a 3-point play. Punch up. Brooks with it. And just about a minute and a half has passed here in the second quarter. And there's the screen. Five to shoot. He shoots it. The shot, no good. So Indiana will take it the other way.
Nice rebound. Trying to match the other team's intensity right now.
Quarter two and about 2 minutes in. Unloads from 13. That won't go for him. Now 0 for 2. Indiana on offense. 8-point game. Pass to Stewart. Quarter two and just under 2.5 minutes gone by. And the shot goes down. He has 6.
And just totally relentless, only increasing the intensity level.
Yeah, he's the guy that you want to go to right now, trying to put this one away.
Now here's Brooks. Well, he hasn't scored yet, but I'm sure that'll change. Doesn't go for him. So Indiana will take it the other way. 13 points was their biggest lead of the game. To the left side wing. Pass to Stewart. Here's the three. Brooks with the rebound. With a step back. He misses it. 0 for 5 and looking off his game right now.
I've not seen him shoot this poorly, guys, in a game this season.
I'll tell you what, it's good to be his age.
Yeah, I don't have memories like that at my age, though.
Well, Grant, it seems like more and more game time is spent with officials huddled around a monitor. You think instant replay has been a positive thing for the league?
Well, for the most part, I think it has been a positive thing. I enjoy it. I think it brings a level of transparency, and also it's important to get the call right. But at times, it does disrupt the flow of a game, and players can't be consumed about winning every call all the time.
And the free throw, no good. Pass to Jones. Back to Brooks. Over to the wing. To stop the drought. Unloads from 13. And he hits the jumper.
And he knows he can make this shot. I mean, clearly there's no indecision for him from there.
There's something to be said about knowing yourself. It allows him to shoot and shoot comfortably, even with taller defenders out there.
Now here's Stewart. Now quiet so far offensively, searching for his first points of the game. Got a piece of it. Brooks with it. Guarded by Stewart. Pass to Jones. Oh, a clear foul there on the missed shot. So he'll get a pair at the line.
I don't mind that. I mean, they met him at the rim and temporarily prevented the points.
Shooting two.
First one falls. So he gets them both. Indiana on offense. They're leading by 8. And here's Johnson. They get it back. Misses in close. Johnson against Brooks.
And they're just one foul now away from the penalty.
Galloway's checked in for Stewart. To the left wing. Back to Jones. Finally gets one to go. That makes him 1 for 5 in this game.
Getting enough shots in close to play inside out.
Here's Johnson. Oh, there's the alley!
A bit undersized. His hops make him a legit small ball four.
So it's the home team now, trailing by 8. Pass to the machine. Now here's Jones. Inside.
The pass, the catch, the slam. What a clean play.
Man, absolutely jaw-dropping. Indiana on offense. Here's Galloway. The home team on D. 6-point game. Here's Johnson. Goes back up. And the layup is up and in. 10 points for him.
It's been a dominant night for him, staying productive throughout.
Here's Jones. And it's off from 3-point range.
And they're doing strong work on the glass. A +5 advantage for them.
Good passing in the paint may be even more important to an offense than great passing on the perimeter. Those are areas where you got to be careful.
Pass to the machine. Now here's Jones. Defense right on him. To the inside. It's stolen by Johnson. Thompson with it. Back to Johnson. Puts it up from 12. No good off the front rim.
And just unable to get anything going tonight. I mean, his teammates have really bailed him out.
They set the pick. Back to Jones. Shot clock at 5. On target from range.
Well, that's a shot he can hit. If you give it to him, you need a little more energy on defense that next trip down.
Pass to Galloway. There's a screen by Johnson. From deep 3-point range, Jones grabs the board.
He's not very hard to defend right now. This is when the defense might step back and let him try to find his range.
And the 3 off target.
And this feels like it's snowballed a little bit on them. The more he tries to shoot his way out of this slump, the worse it seems to get. They need him to get it together.
More points coming from inside. In that respect, they've been the more aggressive team.
So it's the home team now. They trail by 9. Pass to the machine. Now here's Jones, guarded closely. No good there. Indiana on offense. Going inside. That one's off. Shooting 7 for 10 now. And there's 1:45 left to play in the second quarter. Played it in with a nice touch off the window. Jones has got 8 points.
Well, that's how you draw it up right there. A screen to shed the defense. A quick move to the bucket, and you get the lay-in.
Pass to Thompson. Here's Galloway. Still getting warmed up offensively. No buckets yet in the game from him.
Not an easy rebound at all.
But when you win that kind of battle, it gets your blood pumping.
Spins. Puts it up from 12. That shot, no good. So Indiana will take it the other way. The kick out to Johnson. Pass to Galloway. There's the drive. Misses another. He's 0 for 4. And here's Jones. And there's the lob. Thompson pulls it in.
That could have been an easy pass and finish. Not really sure what went wrong.
Yeah, you'd like to keep things a little more simple, and that was a play that didn't quite develop the way they wanted it.
Pass to Jones. Here's the machine. Clock at 6. Back to Jones. The 3. Rebounded by Johnson. Here's Galloway. They swipe it. And so it's Indiana closing out the quarter with a 7-point lead. And it's all due to their ability to own the paint. They've been dominant down low. We're coming right back. Don't go anywhere.
Welcome to this early season edition of the NBA on 2K Sports. Before we analyze that first half, we get to check out the power rankings.
Taking a look here at Indiana, they need to step back and take a look at what's gone wrong. Mistakes have killed them, not just turnovers, but poor decision making. This is a team everyone wants to play right now to get a W.
All right, now let's break down the first half. It's been a productive game so far for Indiana.
And the game plan they went with was very clear. It was centered around scoring inside. Pound that ball inside, pound it in the paint, try to get the high percentage shot. And because of this assertive attitude, they've got the edge where it counts on the scoreboard.
Thanks for tuning in. Now we head back to Brian Anderson for the start of the third quarter.
And we've got third quarter basketball here. Two quarters in the books. Now Stewart. Boy, he's been patient so far. Nothing yet on the scoreboard. Deflects the pass. And for Indiana. No good with a layup.
I'll tell you what, they've been aggressive and they've been physical.
To the wing on the left. Johnson with it. From the elbow. Yep, that one's good. 10 points for him.
Such a critical part of how their offense is going to flow. Things are only working when he seems to be on the floor.
Jones with the ball. Johnson on him. Shot, left block. Thompson pulls it in. Thompson's got 10 rebounds here tonight. So active. Pass to Johnson. Now Stewart. With the drive. Shot blocked. And it's out of bounds to Indiana. How about that strong defensive performance for this half's mobile one block?
Let's see if that block can amp up this team. I mean, they're looking for anything to get themselves going.
And if you're just joining us, we played just over a minute here in the third. Just 4 to shoot. Oh, Thompson from deep three-point land. And they forced the shot clock violation. Great D. So it's the home team now. 9-point game. They set the screen.
Yeah, he tried to gain position, but couldn't quite get there.
And we're just about a minute and a half into the third quarter of basketball. Oh, plenty of contact on that shot. Officials call the foul, and he'll take two free throws now.
Well, that was clearly a foul.
And the first one at the line is good. And that's good as he hits both shots. And we're about a minute and a half in the second half. Stewart against Brooks. Here's the floater. And Stewart with a lay-in. That one's good. Stewart's got his first 2 points.
Such a graceful move. Showing off the floater game.
There's a screen. Here he goes. Ooh, Thompson with the block. And so ball out of bounds. Thompson touched it last. Jackson, he's checked in for Jones. Two minutes gone in this third quarter now. Brooks, right side. Down to five on the shot clock. Pass to the machine. From deep. Thompson pulls it in. Thompson's got 11 rebounds in the game.
Their strong work ethic has been evident on the glass. Really getting after it and being physical.
Stewart into the lane. Yep, that one goes. And it's an 11-point Indiana lead.
Their interior D continues to look shaky. Not a good matchup for them right now.
Jackson, right side. Intercepted! Pass to Thompson. Stewart with it. And he lobs it up top! Stripped it away! Second half of play, and we're 3 minutes into the third here. Can't get it to drop. Indiana on offense. They've only allowed 2 points so far in the second half. So it's both teams making substitutions here. Out left to the wing. Clock at four. Puts it up. The rebound by Jackson. Second half here, and we're just over 3.5 minutes into it. Stewart with it. Jackson in his pocket. Now here's Stewart. With the teardrop. Ooh, excellent D there from Jackson.
If you told me this was the kind of game he was going to have, I would not have expected them to be in front right now.
A shot to stop the drought, and it's good on the lay-in.
Soft touch on the lay-in. Not everyone has that.
Pass to Thompson. Now Stewart. Thompson, a screen on Howard. Now here's Stewart. Tight defense on him. The steal. Jackson outside. The shot that time not on target. So Indiana will take it the other way. 13 points was their biggest lead of the game. Pass to Stewart. This one for three. He drops it from range. Stewart's got 7 points for the quarter.
Just a little bit off in the first, but he's been anything but that here in the second quarter. Really impressive to see him turn it around like that.
They're searching for a way to score.
Yeah, buckets have been very tough to come by.
Here's the machine. 6 points for him. Jackson. Jackson with another miss. To the middle. 6 on the shot clock. And he makes it on the layup.
Something sapped them of their energy defensively since halftime. In the first half, out there scrambling, running, hustling. Since then, not so much. They're doing what they can do to mount a comeback.
In BA, they don't have to get it all back at once. Just focus on making every possession count.
Pass to Howard. That shot is off.
And they're up considerably because of their efforts on the glass.
And he's going for the lob! Trying to go for a lob there. Excellent defense and anticipation to stop it. Takes it inside. Good on the bucket. He's got 6.
Terrific design and execution, leading to an opportunity right at the rim.
To the paint. Fade away. That one a little long. Goes up on the baseline, and he connects with a jumper.
So wide open there, he said, why not? That's like a warm-up shot for him.
Indiana on offense. They've led by as many as 14. Down low. And there's the slam! Dunk to finish it off.
He's pouring it on at a nice clip, and the rest of the team is stepping up as well.
Pass to the machine. Back to Howard. Five on the clock. To the right side. Fires for three. The shot off that time. Indiana on offense. Leading by 12.
Hey, yo, yo, right here, right here.
They set a pick. Can't connect from short range. And he lobs it up. Alley-oop up top. Hammer it home.
I would imagine it's nearly impossible to not get fired up after that play.
Grant, check these guys out on the bench. Their reaction says it all. They are fired up. Time called here. Indiana decides to talk it over.
And one thing I've learned through the years is no matter the situation, there are always adjustments you can make.
Yeah, not just there to pump up or to discipline players. You got to make sure that the coach makes the proper adjustments and has his team in the right mindset to carry it out.
There's a minute 54 left in the third. Here's Galloway. Well, he hasn't put up any points yet in this one. Can't connect from 13 feet out. Pass to Jones.
As the game has gone on, they've had trouble protecting the rock. And just a great job of getting there first and absorbing the contact.
Indiana on offense. They've led by as many as 14. Outside Johnson for three. The offensive rebound. It's good on the putback.
Just great positioning to get the rebound, then get it back up.
Here's the teardrop, and he takes it up and lays it in. He's got seven.
The floater can be a tricky shot, but that's the right choice.
Back to Galloway. 55 seconds left in the third. And he takes the feed in stride and slams it home.
And adds a few more points to their lead, showing off some style.
Wow, that was prime time stuff right there. It's not going to go for him, so Indiana will take it the other way. There's 31 seconds left in the third. Just five on the clock. He takes it in. Can't get it to fall. Pass to Jones. From deep three-point range, no good on the buzzer beater. And so it's Indiana going into the break up 12. Defense is setting the tone. All right, we'll get back to the action after this break. And a moment now as we take a look at our State Farm assist of the game.
He's always near the top of the list for this honor. I mean, passes like these are his specialty.
Doesn't happen with every point guard in the league as far as setting your teammates up. Lots more scorers now, but right there, creating the scoring opportunity for his teammate.
Well, there may not be a lot of drama down the stretch as we head into the fourth quarter, but stranger things have happened. Pass to the machine. Brooks with it. There's a screen. Inside. And it's thrown down hard with both hands.
Oh, yeah. That'll do it.
Wow, an emphatic two-handed slam. And here's Johnson. And for Indiana. Now Stewart. Over Jones. That went off the back iron and out.
Not great numbers, but great effort in this one. Sounds funny, but I think he's been a positive for them.
Back to Brooks. And a miss there with a chance to cut the lead to single digits. And for Indiana. About 1 minute played here in the fourth quarter. Pass to Stewart. And down it goes. 2 points.
Of all the action happening there, it's the assist that jumps out to me there. That's just a great look and a great setup for the bucket.
Now here's Jones to the inside. Thompson with a steal. First minute and a half of basketball played here in the fourth. Outside Johnson. Up and over Brooks. And misses it off the right side of the rim.
Mixing it up inside, just coming up empty-handed.
Pass to the machine. The shot, no good. Indiana on offense. A great fourth quarter, just giving up 2 points. Here's Johnson. The rebound by the machine. Trying to make up ground here.
And with plenty of time left, you want to play with urgency, but not desperation.
Here's Jones. And the layup is good off the glass. If you're just joining us, fourth quarter here. We're just over 2.5 minutes into it. Here's an 8-footer. Thompson's shot is off.
Too much traffic in there. You'd like to see him play with better awareness.
Boy, they need something to go to regain some confidence.
No question. Way too many empty possessions for them.
Had a chance there to cut it to single digits, but it's off target. Pass to Stewart to the middle from 6 feet away. On Monday and then on Wednesday, they kick off a road trip in Boston where they take on the Celtics. Let's get a quick check of the scoring breakdown here for Indiana.
I like how they've taken the high percentage shot in the paint. In the first half, we saw them doing it, and they've continued to succeed as the game has worn on.
The other impressive part about their offense tonight has been their ability to get inside off the bounce. Lots of points in there.
The first free throw is good. It's So hits one and misses one at the line. They've got a chance here to cut the deficit to within 10. And it's Brooks missing.
They're still looking for his first bucket. You can't put all their struggles on him tonight, but he's been brutal.
Back to Stewart. Takes a three. That's bucket number 5. He's 5 for 12 now.
The defense had him confused early on, but he's responded in the second half with some assertive play.
Fourth quarter of play, and over 3.5 minutes have gone by now. Brooks outside. Now here's Jones. He's closely guarded. Some solid defense from Stewart.
You have to credit their effort. I mean, they've done an amazing job on the glass.
Yep, count it.
He drops yet another dime, just facilitating this offense like a maestro.
And if they're going to make a move, this is a good time to start.
And there's still plenty of time, but they definitely don't want to let this game get too far out of hand.
Now here's Brooks. Plenty of space. Basket's good.
That's nice vision there. You see that pass, you make the feed before the defense has a chance to react, and that opens up a much better opportunity to score.
Stewart with it. He's going for the oop here. Hammers the lob through.
Gliding the pass to where it needed to be.
Wow, a strong finish to seal the deal. Brooks against Stewart. Outside Jones. And there's the drive. The shot comes out. So Indiana will take it the other way. Pass to Stewart. Thompson outside. Now here's Stewart. Shot clock at 5. To the paint. And rejected. Stewart's gone 5 for 13 tonight from the floor. Pass to the machine. Brooks outside. Here's the pick.
What's the pick?
Left side Jones. Five to shoot. Let's it go from deep. The shot misses. So Indiana will take it the other way. Out to the wing. A quick shot there. It's off target. They've been having major problems offensively.
Definitely in a bit of a dry spell.
Looking to get it going. Oh, and there's the whistle on the shot. So 2 free throws for him coming up. And he drops the first. And so he makes both from the line.
They're doing some good work at the line this half.
Pass to Stewart from outside the arc. No good on the shot.
And just terrible defense. I don't know how he missed that shot.
And here's Jones. Brooks outside. They set the pick. Here's Jones.
These calls can be so difficult for officials to make. He recognizes players were fatigued and needed time to catch their breath.
And now let's take a look at the New Balance Player of the Game.
Yeah, and it's not surprising. He's really going at the defense inside throughout the entire game. And just showing the D no mercy whatsoever. They constantly were feeding him the ball, clearing out, and letting him do his thing.
You know, I got to applaud his incredible energy out there tonight. Losing again was not an option for him. He wouldn't settle for anything other than a win. And let's swing it over to the sideline and hear from Allie.
Hey, guys. During that last break, I heard Nate McMillan as he talked with the team. He was trying to ignite some fire, saying, "Where's the fight, you guys? You know we can compete with this team, but we're letting them run all over us. We've got to level up the aggressiveness." Back to you.
Thank you for that, Allie. Here's the machine. Shot clock at 6, and he drives in. And he dunks it down.
Just great offense. The screen freeing him up for the slam.
Hey, without that screen, he doesn't get a clean look at the rim.
Yeah, why settle for the layup when you can attack the rim and rise up like that?
Floats one up. Out to the right wing. There's a screen. Here's Stewart. No good that time.
Big rebound there. Now the question is, can they be better on the boards down the stretch? It remains to be seen.
Left side, Jones. Off the mark. Had a chance there to trim it to single digits.
Time for some consideration in the passing category, maybe, Kevin. The shot is just not on. Get somebody else going.
Tipped. Down low, Brooks, and he converts the layup.
His playmaking is something to watch. Threading that pass right in there.
And the foul is called. He missed it, so he's got a couple of free throws coming his way.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
First one falls for him. That one misses. Now here's Jones. Come in. No good there. That would have cut it to single digits. Indiana on offense. At one point, they led by 16. So it'll be two free throws. He was fouled in the act of shooting.
And even from where we're sitting, you could clearly tell it was a foul.
Shooting two.
First free throw is good. So he makes one of two, and the second one misses. A minute 39 left to play in the fourth quarter of this one. No good there. 5 for 11 in the contest. And here's Stewart. Fadeaway Jay is off the mark. 105 left in the fourth. No good. So Indiana will take it the other way. Clock at six. From deep. He's off on that one.
Yeah, and the defense has really got to tighten up on him. I mean, he's just too dangerous from the three-point line.
About 7 seconds separating the shot and game clocks. Stewart against Brooks. And he drops the first. That's also good. So he hits both free throws. 17 seconds left in the final quarter. And so it's a victory for the road team in this one. They have to feel good about this performance. It's one they can be proud of.
Very true. I mean, when you're out on the road, the wins can feel a little sweeter. This one has to feel extra special.
Well, folks, that's going to do it for now. For Ali LaForce, Brent Berry, Grant Hill, and our entire 2K Sports crew, this is Brian Anderson signing off. We'll see you next time.